Go ahead, Mr. President.
We are going to run two meetings concurrently tonight, so I will begin with the public hearing for budget is now open. Is there anyone present who would like to address the board regarding the budget? Then, the board meeting is called to order, and we'll begin with the pledge of allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Okay, next we have public comment. We'll begin with reports. We have two tonight, finance and operations and entertainment and technology. We'll begin with Mrs. Milton.
So our meeting was called to order at 3:10, and we discussed the pre-audit communication. Eric Forberg was here from the independent auditor, Plant and Brand. They reviewed our pre-audit communication that goes to the board each year. He reviewed the auditor responsibilities and scope and timing of the annual audit. He said the audit fieldwork will include three phases. The planning and preliminary information gathering phase is to occur during May and June of 2019, with the rest of the audit procedures taking place during September 2019. Any significant deficiencies and material weaknesses identified in connection with the audit will be communicated to us. He reported that he will also review and report on the new laws related to GASB 84. As required by audit procedures, they met privately, or he met privately with three board members to inquire if they had any financial concerns, and there were none. Proposed budget for 2019-2020. Mark Rader reviewed the different scenarios, including the internal versions 1 and 2, executive version, Senate version, and the House version. Some of the budget variables include student enrollment and foundation allowance. Semi-variable expense changes include fuel, utilities, and insurance. The most likely scenario will include ending up with a slight budget deficit going into 2019-2020 school year. And we adjourn at 4:06.
Thank you, Mrs. Novak. Do we have any questions from the board? If not, we move on to teaching, learning, and technology. Mrs. Novak.
Teaching, Learning, and Technology Committee met on June 10, 2019 at 5 p.m. with Superintendent Wandray, Curriculum Director Michelle Bradford, Casey Allen, Chad Spilsky, Mary Moss present with Mike Keller and myself. Chad presented us on a hockey cooperative agreement, discussed the possibility of entering into a two-year hockey cooperative agreement with North Branch, Lakeville, Otisville, and Elmont. Games will be played at the Crystal Fieldhouse Arena in Burton. It's willing to let us hold games there with Lapeer being the whole school. Steve Sears, our current hockey coach, is willing to continue coaching, including four other schools. The cost would be split between these four schools, minus transportation. The committee is recommending to vote for the full board for vote tonight. And there was questions about like the uniforms and parents. And the parents are all very supportive of this in their district, so we got to that. And then Chad also mentioned, is that in here, about the, maybe it's going to come up at a different, about your, someone can do a community service. What was that? They can do so many hours of community service to get a letter.
Oh, we were talking about the United Way is partnering.
Right.
Is wanting to partner with us about a community service letter. Different.
We talked about it.
Different piece. Just some different things that we have going on.
Okay. Well, I like that. I thought that was then the comprehensive needs assessment district plan presented by Casey Allen and Michelle Bradford, and data was collected over the course of the 18-19 school year and analyzed in the winter spring of 19. Data was collected from the stakeholders' input gathered from multiple meetings where discussions took place, as well as surveys of parents, students, and staff. They identified their successes, gaps, challenges, and causes. In addition, they identified areas to focus on, strategies to implement in the district to and the district improvement plan in order to align with the board's goals. So that was very interesting too. And then they shared the 1920 district improvement plan. We had two other overnight trip requests, Rolling Water 7th grade band choir to Mackinac Island, May 1st through 2nd, 2020. LHS Family Consumer Science World Languages trip to New York City, May 13th, 18th, 2020. And there was another one that came in for track field trip this summer. So we supported the approval of both trips to be sent to this meeting. Any questions?
Not recommending the cross-country trip?
No, I'll tell you about it. It's natural. I remember talking about it. No, it was this summer.
That came at a later date.
Oh, gotcha.
Or that was more out there. Does take us to action items. We'll begin with that consent for meeting that includes the approval of the minutes of June 5th regular meeting. We have the overnight trip requests for the Rolling Water 7th grade band to Mackinac Island, the Lapeer High School Family Consumer Science and World Language students to New York City, which Mary said she volunteered to go. Overnight trip request for boys cross country students for Percy.
I'll make a motion that they're reading the minutes and waiving the consent agenda items to be approved as presented.
I'll support.
Motion and supported. Mrs. Peabody?
Yes.
Mrs. Novak?
Aye.
Mr. Nolan?
Aye.
Mrs. Putnam?
Aye.
Mr. Hager?
Aye.
Mrs. Becker?
Aye.
Mr. Kelly?
Aye.
Carries. Next, that takes us to the hockey cooperative agreement.
I'll move the cooperative hockey agreement between your high school, Elma, Lake Hill, and River Branch High School is effective August 1, 2018.
I'll support that. And move to support. Are there any questions on motion? Any discussion?
This one. If we don't do this yet, does that mean there's no hockey?
It's going to be really hard, Mike. I think we have about 7 kids, maybe 10 if we get a couple freshmen that come back. We only had 13 when we finished this year. We graduated 6. And it's been going that way for the last couple of years. Matt and I had talked a few years ago about possibly dissolving it. And we had a bunch of parents show up, and we had a good turnout that year, and some of those kids have stayed over. But it's dwindling. You know, we look at a lot of different districts, and you look at Oxford, and they have a co-op with Avondale just to make their program going, and that's a bigger school than ours. These three schools were a part of another conglomerate group, and Goodrich was one of them. So Goodrich and Northridge are kind of the two schools that gave the most kids to the Alliance program, and Goodrich is now looking to co-op with Lake Fenton area and Brandon, just closer in proximity. So when Jim Fish called me and we started kind of looking at all these different things, we're probably talking, you know, 2 to 3 kids from each school besides ours, which puts us around that 15 mark. I'm hoping we can get up to 20. It's still small, but if we don't do it, I don't know. And Steve and I have had this conversation a lot too, Steve Sears. I don't know how much longer hockey's going to last in Lapeer.
Thank you. Just
want to
take careful coordination, especially when you have members in different schools that are playing. We have a motion that's been supported. Mrs. Becker?
Aye.
Mr. Hagenholm?
Aye.
Mrs. Putnam?
Aye.
Mr. Nolan?
Aye.
Mrs. Novak?
Aye.
Mrs. Peabody?
Yes, aye.
Mr. Kelly to that, and motion carries. Okay. It takes us to the 2018-2019 final budget amendment. We have a number of motions that need to be.
We'll make a motion that the
the 2018-2019 general fund amendments be approved as presented.
Support.
Discussion on the motion. Mrs. Peabody?
Yes.
Mrs. Novak?
Aye.
Mr. Nolan?
Aye.
Mrs. Sutton?
Aye.
Mr. Hagel?
Aye.
Mrs. Becker?
Aye.
Ellis, aye, motion carries.
I'll make a motion that the 2018-2019 food service fund amendments be approved as presented.
Okay.
Moved and supported. Questions on the motion? Discussion? Mrs. Peabody?
Yes.
Mrs. Novak?
Aye.
Mr. Nolan?
Aye.
Mrs. Sutton?
Aye.
Mr. Hagel?
Aye.
Mrs. Becker?
Aye.
Ellis, aye, motion carries. The 2018-2019-2013 limited tax school building and site projects debt retirement fund.
I think the first time to us, I remember that the 2018-2019-2013 limited tax school building and site funds debt retirement fund amendments be approved.
I'll support. Been supported. Any discussion on the motion? See, Mrs. Becker?
Aye.
Mr. Hagel?
Aye.
Mrs. Sutton?
Aye.
Mr. Nolan?
Aye.
Mrs. Novak?
Aye.
Mrs. Peabody?
Aye.
Ellis, aye, motion carries.
And I'll make a motion that the 2018-2019-2014 limited tax school building and site funds debt retirement fund amendments be approved as presented.
Support.
Moved and supported. Is there any discussion? Mrs. Peabody?
Aye.
Mrs. Novak?
Aye.
Mr. Nolan?
Aye.
Mrs. Sutton?
Aye.
Mr. Hagel?
Aye.
Mrs. Becker?
Aye.
Mr. Ellis, aye, that motion is carried.
I move that the 2018-2019-2015 limited tax school building and site fund debt retirement fund amendments be approved as presented.
Support.
Any discussion on the motion? Mrs. Becker?
Aye.
Mr. Hagel?
Aye.
Mrs. Sutton?
Aye.
Mr. Nolan?
Aye.
Mrs. Novak?
Aye.
Mrs. Peabody?
Yes.
Mr. Ellis, aye, motion carries. Take this word, final.
I'll motion that the 2016 limited tax school building and site bonds debt retirement fund amendments be approved as presented.
Supported.
Just say 2018.
2018-19.
I have a motion. Did it get supported?
Yes.
Okay.
Who supported that?
I.
No. Thank you. Is there any discussion on the motion? Mrs. Peabody?
Aye.
Mrs. Novak?
Aye.
Mr. Nolan?
Aye.
Mrs. Sutton?
Aye.
Mr. Hagel?
Aye.
Mrs. Becker?
Aye.
Ellis, aye, and motion carries. Now, the public hearing for the budget is now closed, and we will move to the adoption of the budget. That takes us to 2019-2020 budget.
I'll make a motion that the 2019-2020 general fund budget be adopted as presented.
Supported.
That move been supported. Is there any discussion?
Just one comment. I noticed that it's page 45 of our packet, but anybody who would have looked at this would say, well, why are you doing this with a projected deficit? I just want to remind everybody that when you look at last year, we were at almost 1.4 million projected deficit at the end of the year, 38,583 in the good. And so, considering the fact that our projected deficit is about one third of what we thought it would be last year, hopefully we all think we're going to end up positive this year as well. But given all the uncertainties, I don't know if we have much of a choice. Just wanted to point that out. It was kind of a big shift last year, and I'm hoping for that this year too.
That's also the reality.
Right.
Are the numbers increasing with the homeschool partnership?
Well, we've already done the audit for this year, so we don't know what it looks like next year.
I mean, in the fall.
We don't know yet, but all signs point to yes.
Well, did you call comment?
I based the formative years on the magic eight ball responses, so yeah.
I just think that's been a positive situation.
Early college, virtual and home school partnership, FTE improvement has been significant in our budget.
Any other discussion or motion? Mrs. Becker.
Aye.
Mr. Hagan.
Aye.
Mrs. Butler.
Aye.
Mr. Nolan.
Aye.
Mrs. Novak.
Aye.
Mrs. Peabody.
Yes.
Mr. Keller says aye, and that motion carries.
I'll make a motion that the 2019-2020 food service fund budget be adopted as presented.
Support. Movement supported. Any discussion on the motion? Mrs. Peabody.
Yes.
Mrs. Novak. Mr. Nolan.
Aye.
Mrs. Butler.
Aye.
Mr. Hagan.
Aye.
Mrs. Becker.
Aye.
Keller says aye, and that motion carries.
I move that the 2019-2020 student activity fund budget be adopted as presented.
Supported. Supported. Any discussion? None. Mrs. Becker.
Aye.
Mr. Hagan.
Aye.
Mrs. Butler.
Aye.
Mr. Nolan.
Aye.
Mrs. Novak.
Aye.
Mrs. Peabody.
Yes.
Mr. Keller.
Aye.
And I'll tackle the next one here. I move that the 2019-2020-2013 limited tax school building and site funds debt retirement fund be adopted as presented.
Forward.
Okay.
No, we're good.
Thanks. Do we have support on that?
Yes.
Yes. Thank you. Any discussion on the motion? None. Mrs. Becker.
Aye.
Mr. Hagan.
Aye.
Mrs. Butler.
Aye.
Mr. Nolan.
Aye.
Mrs. Novak.
Aye.
Mrs. Peabody.
Yes.
Keller says aye, and that motion carries.
I'll motion that the 2019-2020-2014 limited tax school building and site bonds debt retirement fund budget be adopted as presented.
Support.
Moved and supported. Is there any discussion? Mrs. Peabody.
Yes.
Mrs. Novak.
Aye.
Mr. Nolan.
Aye.
Mrs. Butler.
Aye.
Mr. Hagan.
Aye.
Mrs. Becker.
Aye.
Mrs. Keller says aye, and that motion carries.
I'll move that the 2019-2020-2015 limited tax school building and site bonds debt retirement fund budget be adopted as presented.
Support.
Moved and supported. Discussion on the motion. None. Mrs. Becker.
Aye.
Mr. Hagan.
Aye.
Mrs. Butler.
Aye.
Mr. Nolan.
Aye.
Mrs. Novak.
Aye.
Mrs. Peabody.
Yes.
Mrs. Keller says aye, and motion carries.
I move that the 2019-2020-2016 limited tax school building and site bonds debt retirement fund budget be adopted as presented.
Support. Moved and supported. Is there any discussion? None. Mrs. Peabody.
Yes.
Mrs. Novak.
Aye.
Mr. Nolan.
Aye.
Mrs. Butler.
Aye.
Mr. Hagan.
Aye.
Mrs. Becker.
Aye.
Mr. Keller says aye, and motion carries. That takes us to the cash flow borrowing resolution.
I move the cash flow borrowing resolution be approved as presented.
Support. Moved and supported. Is there any discussion on the motion? Seeing none. Mrs. Becker.
Aye.
Mr. Hagan.
Aye.
Mrs. Butler.
Aye.
Mr. Nolan.
Aye.
Mrs. Novak.
Aye.
Mrs. Peabody.
Yes.
Mr. Hagan says aye. Takes us to the application.
want to move that because it's such enjoyable reading. I move that the application for preliminary qualification of bonds resolution be approved.
I'll support. Go ahead, Summer.
The move and support. Is there any discussion on the motion? Mrs. Becker.
Aye.
Mr. Hagel.
Aye.
Mrs. Putnam.
Aye.
Mr. Nolan.
Aye.
Mrs. Novak.
Aye.
Mrs. Peabody.
No.
Sellers is aye. Here are our action items tonight. Are there any board member communications?
I'd like to again congratulate all graduates. The two graduation ceremonies that were at were very, very nice. Congratulations, Mr. Lindsay. Got lots of feedback on how organized the graduation process was on Sunday. So it's just a fun time watching all graduates from three on Facebook to older years. It's cool to see all the kids all excited, even the adult ed. They're happy. Congratulations.
I'd just like to say thank you to Mark and staff for all the work with the budget. I know it's not easy, these are trying times, and with all the information that's not available, and I commend you because I've done this before and I get it. Thank you.
I did all that, thank you. A lot of work I know has gone into that, so I appreciate that. And keeping your crystal ball open.
That you don't have.
And I do also echo the graduations. I got to attend two of them, and it was quite an honor to actually be up there and, you know, be able to share that day with the students. That was really great.
Communications tonight.
It's real briefly. I agree with everything you've all said, and Doug and your staff. I think it's fantastic the way you guys organize everything and make it so easy for us. And I'm sorry, I'm a little bit on that. And Mark and your crew, I thank you again. I don't know how you do it. Year after year, this year, you have even far less information than we have before. And it doesn't look like we're going to have any information on it anytime soon. So, also, I wanted to just put out there as sort of a reminder to anybody who might look at this, but I've been approached by, I won't say a lot of people, but several people lately who've said to me, I really think you guys are on the right track with what you wanted to. They really want to hear more about the bond proposal. They're ready to hear more. And so I tell everybody, hey, look, it's coming soon. I've had a couple of people tell me that they're concerned that this is too big of a bite of the apple, to which I reminded them, this is our opportunity to control our fate. And they all seem to get that. So at least they do to my face. I hope they get it all the way around. But when I tell them that if we don't do this, then things are going to control us instead of us trying to control them, I hope that everyone gets on board with that message and puts that out there, that this is Lapeer's opportunity to control where Lapeer takes its educational experience itself. So let's put that out there.
Thanks, Mike. Really good work.
I've only got one thing tonight. Denise, welcome back.
I was going to say that too.
Damn, so that's the first one to say it. Good job, Brad.
Thank you. I'm so sad that I missed so much stuff. Wrong timing on that one, but.
Graduation is your favorite.
Graduation and employee recognition this year. Everybody was getting award I was so excited about. And I was like, dang. I missed that too. So, yeah. I was like, very glad to be back though.
Well, Denise, it is good to have you back. Please stay back.
Yeah, thanks.
So, you know, watch yourself there.
Yeah, it's over there. No, it's not.
I push you on the opposite end of the table, so I could have you.
We're actually doing stuff with this thing over here.
In July, we'll have our organizational meeting, and that is when we switch up on board partners for schools. So just start thinking about if there's a school that you might want to partner with, and we'll make that happen. Again, so, That's really all I have tonight.
Mr. Lapeer?
Thank you, Mr. President. Welcome back, Denise. It's comforting to have you at the table again and back. So I ran into your husband one day downtown. And I think we said it at the market. He just ran out of things to talk about. I don't know what else to say at this point, so I'm glad to have you. Special thanks to Mark, Danielle, and the business office, echoing what the board has had to say. It's been a particularly interesting year in the budget cycle, with no doubt with respect to the transfer of power in Lansing, but we have a good team. And, you know, it's this time of year when we do the final budget adoption, when we take a look at the previous year's budget and we examine everything from a financial perspective, it's really important to recognize the business office, not from the perspective of, hey, great job in the numbers, we ended up better than we thought we would, but to really understand the philosophy with which they operate, which is we don't start with no, not we don't start with whether we can afford it or not. We ask the right questions, right? How is it good for kids? You know, how's it going to benefit the program, the district mission and vision, and then we work from that perspective. And so I always appreciate the fact that we have that level of care and understanding from the business office. That's not common, it's not typical. And so we really appreciate their approach. So thank you for what you guys do in making all of this possible. And really, when you look back at the budget and you consider that this district has been in declining enrollment status for going on over 15 years, the fact that we're able to, you know, we've already thanked Kim and her staff for being able to figure out a way to bargain contracts to return some money to our units, to put money into our fund equity, to really operate efficiently and effectively. We made some tough decisions as a board, closed some buildings, added programs for kids. All of that, this is a good time to remember the good things we're doing in difficult financial circumstances. And finally, I just wanted to let the board know a couple of our administrative members are in the room. Lots of change you saw coming for 19-20. Every time we talk about departures and turnover in the administrative ranks, it's an opportunity to review our current structure and make some adjustments. You know me, we like to take a comprehensive look every time that happens. The parents, the staffs, the administrators themselves have been great about having the discussions that led up to that final decision. I can tell you that the level of discussion, the amount of hand-wringing and debate and consideration that went into that ultimate email to the entire staff and to you as a board was considerable. So I made mention of it at the time, but anyone that wants to meet with me individually and have a discussion about kind of the A, the B, the C, and all the movement, I invite that conversation. So thanks to our membership. We also, in the budget, and as part of that change, took great care to return some support to the buildings that has been reduced over the course of the last few budget cycles, some much-needed secretarial support and dean of students support. A lot of that discussion came out of our budget manager's process, where we do talk about what to cut, but we also talk about what's not working and what do you guys need in the buildings and what do you think, what's out there, what's certain out there. And all of these services that we want to provide, you know, when you start reducing that many people, you have to begin to understand the law of diminishing returns. And so a lot of happy people in the organization with the increase in secretarial and dean support. And those were not cuts that we felt good about when we made them at the time. But to be in a financial position, again, go back to what we're here today, which is to, you know, approve the final budget amendment for this fiscal year and approve next year's projected budget. We're in a great position to be able to do that. Right, to be able to say, hey, let's hire some more folks to get the support where it needs to be in our building, supporting our kids and our staff.
Okay. Very encouraging.
Yeah.
I know it's tough to make change, but I always say that education has a hard side, a hard time with the business side of things, and I think we do business great. I think we do better.
Hey. Lapeer Community Schools, we do business great. We have two taglines tonight.
Yeah.
We control our fate,
I'd be really interested.
Mr. Nolan?
Mark knows, from an audit perspective, you change people up, and that's just the way it goes.
Yeah.
I'd really be interested to see how many other school districts added to their fund balance this year.
Sure, we can, there's a couple different ways to identify that. We won't know until all the budgets are finalized and approved, but could, do they pull that out of IDEX, Mark?
Can we do it on IDEX, or can you do it on Office 72?
Yeah.
How many of your teachers will you have to share?
Well, that's a number that's in flux, because as resignations and retirements happen over the course of the summer months, we, and if you remember, part of this end of the year amendment process has us flush out what the either positive or negative budget variance numbers are relative to the number of teachers that retired and resigned and who they were replaced with. So there's not a number of teachers that we have to hire, because we hired one yesterday, we hired one today, we'll get a retirement or resignation notice tomorrow and have to go out and post. So it's a number that will be fluid until the first day of school. Hopefully we can get it all done before the first day of school, but it's inevitable. It happens every year where something happens in someone's life that they can't return. And so we'll have that number, you know, hard and fast when we come back, you know, September, October board meetings. We'll know for sure.
Like, I just remember last year the room was full of the teachers. That was really nice.
Yeah, we had a lot of first years last year.
Yeah,
that was a fun summer. A lot of good hiring. Yeah. That's it for me.
That's it.
I'm going to finish being back on something that I know is not a
question.
I really want to highlight your comment, though, where you said we don't start from a perspective of no. And that has absolutely been, and Mr. Denning will tell you from years ago until now, whether it was Kevin or now with Mark, and Mark's taking it the next step. We don't start with no. We start with, we'll find a way, or let's look at it a different way. It's been incredible to watch. I know of many other organizations and many other school districts where they do start. No, we can't do that. It's not in the budget. These guys have been amazing to find new ways to do that.
Absolutely. And I think the credit also trickles down to our department directors and operations, like the Thompson and Transportation, like Mark Meisner and operations, right? Like NIC and technology, you know, like food service. The buy-in from the support groups and operations who really are bottom-line folks, right? Because we're like, hey, here's our budget, they're limited. They understand, like no other group of operational staff I've ever seen, that the educational component of what we do comes first. And they really, truly see themselves as a service to make that end happen. So they, will the answer sometimes be, maybe not the way you guys want it? Yes, but they never start there.
No.
Yeah, you're right.
Motion to adjourn.
Motion to adjourn.
Yes.
Go back.
Aye.
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 Aye.